Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your market outlook for Tuesday, June 4th, 2013. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures and commodities are slightly below fair value, so we're looking for a little selling at the open on Tuesday morning. Just one presentation for both markets this morning. We had a major sell-off on Friday, had a little recovery on Monday. A lot of people are excited that the Dow was up over 100 points yesterday. No real reason to get overly excited. It was from a handful of stocks. And so, you know, the headline looks good, but the reality is we couldn't take out the previous day's high, couldn't take out the previous day's low. So for the Dow itself, it was a day of indecision. Now, the rest of the major indexes, while a lot of them closed higher on the day, they actually made lower lows yesterday, and we'll look at that in a couple of minutes. Now, the headline stocks that drove the Dow higher yesterday, Intel had a nice big pop. Apparently, it's finally going to get involved in tablets. We saw Merck had a nice big pop yesterday, lost a lot of its gains going into the close, and actually had a bearish reversal day. Microsoft moved higher. Bank of America was the big loser in the Dow 30 on Monday. And like a lot of bank stocks, traded down to the lower channel line yesterday and then recovered going into the close. So a close below 1326 would give us a sell signal for Bank of America on Tuesday. Now, last week we were looking for a breakdown below 1640 for the S&P 500. And we certainly got that on Friday. We recovered back up to the bottom of the flypaper channel on Monday. But as you can see, we've made a series of lower highs over the past couple of weeks. And so there's our big line in the sand up here. But we keep moving farther and farther away from retesting that recent high. Now, the VIX continues to move higher. So here we are making higher highs and higher lows for the VIX. So stock options traders are certainly spooked at the moment. We're not seeing that in the Dow 30 stocks, but obviously these people have a reason to be worried about the future. For the TSX, we were looking for a breakdown below 12,600. Saw that on Monday, and now we have a new daily sell signal for the Toronto Stock Exchange. We had an inside day for the bond market on Monday, a nice big reversal for the VIX yesterday. After the VIX made a new high for this move, it came right down and closed slightly below where it opened, but certainly did not really penetrate the previous day's bar and certainly came nowhere near the previous day's low. That would be the first sign that something new is happening here. The VIX for the Nasdaq made a new high for this move yesterday and closed higher on the day. So while we have the VIX for both of the major indexes, still on buy signals here, I remain skeptical about the market being able to make new highs at this time. Looking at the overnight market for Australia, we saw a little buying there. Nice reversal, but certainly nowhere near a new trend. We saw some selling in Hong Kong, made a new low for this move. Some selling in Shanghai, and we're now back on a sell signal for the mainland Chinese market. We saw a little buying in the Nikkei in Tokyo, but certainly nowhere near a new trend starting for the Japanese stock market. Taking a look at commodity prices, copper came up to the upper channel line on Monday. A close above 41.28 would give us a new buy signal. Looking at the GLD, we saw a buy signal on Thursday, some selling on Friday, some buying on Monday, and we're seeing a little selling on Tuesday. A close below 133.79 would give us a new sell signal on Monday. For platinum, we saw a buy signal on Thursday, sell signal on Friday, and a buy signal on Monday. So not a pretty picture for platinum at the moment. And for silver, looking for a close above 22.08 on Monday to give us a buy signal. No change in trend for crude oil on Monday. No change for gasoline. A close above 56.53 would give us a buy signal. And absolutely no change for natural gas on Monday. Next up, let's take a look at the U.S. market. And of course, the first sign of anything new happening here is going to be a move above Friday's high. Day traders will be looking for a move up to sell it at that point. And so we really need to see a breakout above Friday's high in the S&P 500 or the NASDAQ 100. You'll notice that both of these indexes, unlike the Dow, made lower lows yesterday. We saw bank stocks, just like Bank of America, come down to the lower channel line but recover going into the close. Energy stocks had an inside day on Monday. Gold and silver stocks continue to move higher on Monday, looking for a breakout here above 112.50. That's the point where the market has retreated twice in the last month. Taking a look at transports, they made a lower low yesterday, recovered most of their losses going into the close. And utilities, another index that recovered going into the close, but made another lower low for this move. Next up, let's take a look at the Canadian stock market. And we now have the TSX on a sell signal as of Monday's close. A close on Tuesday above 12,725 would give us a new buy signal. Not expecting to see that. We saw weakness in the energy sector yesterday and actually traded through the lower channel line, but did not close below it. So a close below 251.04 would give us a new sell signal on Tuesday. Looking at financial services, they're on their second day of a sell signal. Gold stocks still holding up here, continuing to move higher. Materials had an inside day of an inside day. We saw some selling in the mining sector on Monday. We saw some continued selling in the telecom sector on Monday, and so that sector has been down 4 days in a row. I've got the venture stocks, a lot of mining, gold mining stocks in the venture exchange, of course, and so that index has been on a buy signal for a couple of days now. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. S&P 500 actually closed above the upper channel line on Monday, so we're coming into Tuesday on an intraday buy signal. First sign of weakness on Tuesday is going to be an hourly close below 1632.51. Similar situation for the Nasdaq 100. First sign of weakness on Tuesday is going to be an hourly close below 2973.84. And for the TSX, we ended Monday on a sell signal, closing below the lower channel line. First sign of strength on Tuesday is going to be an hourly close above 12,644. Okay, folks, that's all for Tuesday morning. Just looking over my shoulder, it looks like the futures have firmed up a little. So we're looking for a flat open on Tuesday morning. Again, if we do see some continued buying on Tuesday, the first sign that anything new is happening is a takeout of last Friday's high. No matter what index or stock you're looking at, that'll be the first sign that something new is happening. But I'm not expecting that to happen this week. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Wednesday morning.